censor the media and a
threat to democracy.
Inaccuracies anywhere.
The First Amendment.
The federal policy, freedom of the press, impacts our lives by allowing news journalists to report news without fear of being punished by the government. The First Amendment's freedom of the press is an effective policy, and the government should not interfere with it or implement more regulations on this policy. While media bias is present in our news sources, this is not the federal government's responsibility to control. Control of bias should stem from news organizations and American citizens who take in the information from these sources.
Media bias is a warped perception of a news story that is reported by journalists and taken in by Americans. While many people believe that bias comes strictly from news organizations, it is also generated by the audience. When people don't have a diverse portfolio of news sources, it allows them to take in the bias of that one site. Media bias is a problem in our everyday lives because it creates a divide among the American people, causing major polarization in our ideas and beliefs.
More federal regulation of freedom of the press would most likely have more negative effects than positive.
But I don't really think that government regulation is the answer, because it could absolutely squelch the very people who are supposed to be guarding the government, and the business that they're after.
Further government restrictions would only increase media bias, because journalists would be more fearful of the punishment that could come from reporting information on the government. This fear would be present even if the information was true, potentially causing more false media. In our government, it is our judicial branch's duty to interpret the laws created by our legislative branch. The current government regulations, while minimal, have been created by previous Supreme Court cases and precedent of other trials. These include the doctrine of prior restraint and libel laws.
In the Supreme Court case, Near v. Minnesota in 1931, the precedent of how prior restraint would be implemented was determined. They decided that, while in this case prior restraint was not applicable, it was, in fact, a constitutional law under extreme circumstances, such as something that is harmful to the American people as a whole and to our country. Later in the Supreme Court case, New York Times Company v. United States in 1971, they further elaborated on what would be deemed harmful speech towards the government. These justices decided that in this case, the information given as reason for prior restraint was too vague, and did not give the government the right to censor the New York Times Company. In order for prior restraint to be used, the claims have to be specific and prevalent to our national security.
In the trial of John Peter Zenger in 1733, he was accused of libel, the written vilification of a person, for printing jarring information about a government official. The court decided that you cannot be convicted of libel if the information published is true information. This gave more leeway for journalists to publish information on the government. While this was before the United States was established, it set the example for how freedom of the press would be implemented into our Bill of Rights later on.
With the British and with, you know, on the town square and people getting arrested for criticizing the king. So there was a lot of thought put in it by the founding fathers. They wanted to protect that right for us to be able to speak out without the government squelching it.
These regulations already provide us enough protection from false information without letting the government have ultimate control over what news organizations can publish. If there was a broader interpretation of what prior restraint is, the American people would only get one side of the story from every news source. Currently, you can still receive both sides from different sources if you choose to research diligently. More regulation would take away this ability to receive the full story.
The need for control of media bias is a prevalent issue in our country, and in some cases, government intervention has been used. The government is put in place to protect our rights, and there have been a few regulations put in place for a reason. In the federal court case, Hazelwood v. Kuhlmeier, 1998, the court sided against the press, in this case being a school newspaper. Hazelwood East High School is a public school, making it a federal institution. The school placed restrictions on what the students could say in the newspaper. The court decided that the press could be censored by the school. It was found necessary for the school to not allow their students to publish this article in order to provide security and safety for the school. However, one effect of this censoring of the newspaper could be that it leads to further bias by federal institutions. The federal government could use the censoring power to control what the press can publish, possibly allowing a bias in the story to be made. This could potentially further the problem of media bias rather than solving it.
The solution to progressive media bias comes from fact-checking and taking in a broad range of news sources.
But the point is to look at both sides. And people always tell me I've done my research, and that means they watched a YouTube video. No, seriously, do what you can to get both sides of the story and find the middle ground, because there always is a middle ground. There's always a place where the truth lies.
Every citizen can take control of their intake of bias by following these steps. This is the safest way to limit your consumption of false information while still letting journalists give their side of the story.
That's the challenge, right? When people see fact checks, people become more accurate.
Fact checking is when people take an active approach to making sure news sources that they are viewing are correct. Personal bias also can contribute in what news sources a person watches. By keeping an open mind, pick middle ground news sources that don't align with what political party you affiliate with.
The federal policy, Freedom of the Press, allows news sites and journalists to effectively produce information to American citizens. The government regulations that are implemented by the judicial branch are not harsh, but still protect our rights.
The government should not make any changes to this clause because we, the American people, would be even more negatively affected by regulations than we are currently by media bias.